Hey everyone, No Guts No Glory here. How's everyone doing? Welcome back to my channel. Glad to have each and every one of you here. We truly appreciate all of you guys' support and the awesome comments that you leave on our channel. Let's see, this is going to be a Bath & Body Works haul. They had their semi-annual sale and I did that online and I just recently received it and I thought I'd share it with you guys. A little update. First, I'm drinking the other one that I had bought of the espresso cafe and the vanilla. The other one was caramel. The vanilla, I have to say, is better than the caramel. I can tolerate it a little bit more. Would I repurchase it again? Still no. Hell no. Because it's just a little too strong for me. But let's see. Dad, thank you. First of all, I want to thank each and every one of you who sent good thoughts, good vibes, well wishes, prayers, everything. We truly, truly appreciate it. When I asked for it the other day on my prayer request for a couple of family members of mine. Update on that. Dad is doing a lot better. My father-in-law is doing a lot better. His pneumonia is just about all gone. He's taking his antibiotics. So he's doing a lot better with that. On the other hand, he fell again. This is like his third or fourth fall in about 2 weeks, 2.5 weeks time. So he does use his walker in the house. He's stubborn, very, very bullheaded and stubborn man. He doesn't like to be told what to do, when to do it, and how to do it. We're trying to get him to stop driving. Woo, trying to take away keys from a man who's bullheaded. Not a pretty sight. So we're dealing with that, and we're looking into trying to get someone to come in while his wife is at work. Like I said before, she's an RN. She works at a nursing home and she works second shift. So we're looking into trying to get somebody to come in maybe while she's at work 2 or 3 hours a day, just to make sure he's had his dinner, he's doing okay, if he needs cleaned up, things like that, you know? So we're looking into that. Then we're also looking into getting a shower put into his bathroom. All he has right now, the house is very old. So the bathroom that he has access to, that he can get to, only has a tub. It has no shower whatsoever. It's just a tub. Well, the other day, Brad got a call that he had to come over and help get him out of the tub because he gets in the tub, okay. Well, not really okay. You know how you gotta lift your leg to obviously get over that, you know, and to get into the tub. Well, his legs are very weak, and so he has trouble also with that. Once he gets in, then now he has trouble getting out. So we're looking at into having that removed and having a walk-in shower put in there for him. So then he can have a big shower chair put in there for him as well, and some handles. So we're looking into all of that to get that done for him ASAP. Anything else? So that's what's going on with him. My brother-in-law's grandson is doing a lot better. Like I said, he's no longer in ICU and he is now home. The pressure's been relieved. It's been a while now, so they've put that part of his skull back on in place, and so they've sent him home. And yeah, he's got a long road to hoe as far as getting up and mobility and things like that, since I told you before, he had broke his neck. So, but he can walk, and he's, thank you God, you know, that he's still able to do a lot of things. It's just, yeah, a little bit of therapy and he'll be back, yeah, back to normal. So that's the update there on that. So thank you so very much for all the prayers. Prayer really helps. It truly, truly does. Anything else to fill you in on? I went for my knees. A lot of you wanted to know the outcome of my appointment finally for my knee. Okay, went to see the specialist. This is the outcome. He took some more x-rays again. He showed them to me. He explained everything. Okay, your knee is like this, okay? There's the two bones there meet like this. In between those two bones is some ligaments, all right, that help to when the knee bends like this and stuff, all right? That ligament there is what's torn on my knee. It's torn. It will not repair itself. The only way to repair it is surgery. Now, he says, if I'm going to go in to repair that, I might as well just go in and do a whole knee replacement, period. Because you need that altogether. Because not only is that torn there, that ligament in between them, the cartilage that covers the two bones that helps move that also nice and smoothly, mine is all gone. I have nothing but bone on bone. And then he showed me that I also have spurs in there, quite a few spurs, and I have extreme arthritis in there as well. So he said, with all of that going on, you might as well just have a whole knee replacement. I said, okay, what else can I do besides that? Because I'm not ready for that step yet. He said, I can get a shot in my knee for a set of three of them. I go once a week for 3 weeks and get one each week. And that will, excuse the noise, the cat and the dog are playing. But that will help with some of the mobility, you know. It will give me a little bit of relief. Hopefully, he says it depends on the person. Sometimes it could last 6 months, sometimes it could last a year, and sometimes it could last a day or two. It depends. So I'm gonna go that route. So he said you can do the three shots, and then after the three shots, all you have left to do is you're gonna have to wear the brace indefinitely, all the time. Every day, all the time. So, three shots, wear the brace continuously until I decide when to have the knee replacement. That's where I'm at. There is no other fix for it. I just gotta bite the bullet and get it done one of these days. And I don't know, right now, I'd rather do this route and live it with it this way for right now. I'm just not ready yet for that. Because, and I'll explain why. Because I want to get more weight off. The more weight I can get off, the easier my recovery will be for my knee replacement. So if I did it right now with still so much weight on, it'll be a longer recovery. Long road to hoe. So I'm just waiting it out and doing the best I can to get some more weight off, and then I will get that surgery done. So there's your update. All right, now let's get into this damn haul, huh? A lot of you just like, yeah, what the, shut the f-. All right, semi-annual sale. A lot of you know I love, absolutely positively love candles. Yes, I do. So I got myself only three. I refrained. So let me go ahead and open the first one here and show you what I got. Hubby already smelled them. He said, awesome choices. So there you go. The first one is Vanilla Bean Noel. That's the first one that I got. Looks like that. It says that it is vanilla bean, marshmallow fluff, and vanilla cake. OMG! Oh, it smells like a bakery. Yeah, Simon even agrees. Oh, it smells so good. So that is a winner. If you like something sweet and smells like you cooked and baked all day, then that's one you should get. So, and then the next one that I got here is, get it out of its little case here. All right. This one is cinnamon caramel swirl. And this one says that it's gooey caramel, grated cinnamon, vanilla bean, and maple brown sugar. Oh, wow. Right away, you get the maple and the brown sugar. Oh, that smells divine. So there you go. These are normally $24.50 each. You can see that's what they normally are. And then the third one here is Campfire Donut. This one says it's also a $24.50 candle, made with notes of powdered sugar, glazed donut, and cedarwood essential oil. It's sweet. They're all sweet. But they all have one thing in common, like a buttery cream smell. This one and the vanilla bean. The other one smell more maple brown sugar, cinnamon. Oh, they smell so good. So those are the three that I got. And as you can see here on my invoice, I only paid $8 a piece for the semi-annual sale. So they were $8 a piece on that. Then I went outside of my comfort zone because a lot of you know when I do a Bath and Body Works haul, the majority of the time, all I get is candles. Now, went to see my doctor the other day. When I went to see her, she came in the room. She went to listen to my heart, and she got close to me, and I can smell her perfume. Something that smelled really good. And I said to her, "Oh my goodness, what are you wearing?" I said, "Because you smell like cotton candy. You smell really sweet." And she said, "Oh, I'm wearing something from Bath and Body Works." And I said, "What's that?" And she said, "Vanilla Bean Noel Lotion." And I said, "Oh my God, well, that smells really good." So when I did this semi-annual haul thing, buying online, I got it. I thought, that smelled so damn good, I'm gonna get it. So I got myself one. And it was $2.60. So, and it, oh my gosh, guys. I know a lot of you are already familiar with this scent, but it smells so good. And one thing about their cream, as you can see, it's really thick, it's not runny. Oh. Oh my goodness. It smells so good. Now people can say, "Oh, you smell like you've been baking all day." I'll say, "Yes." All right, then also two things that I've never seen me really haul before. I got myself two hand soaps. So these are the two that I got. They were $2.40 a piece. This one's the Cinnamon Caramel Swirl Creamy Luxe Hand Soap. And the other one is Winter Candy Apple. Now, if you can see, I'm going to open them now because I want to smell them and see what they smell like. I've never used their hand soaps before, so I don't know. I guess they're good. Seen a lot of you guys buy them and haul them before. Now, trying to get this plastic off of here is going to be a chore. I can see that already. All right. Oh my goodness. Really? It's like getting into Fort Knox here just to get the plastic off. All right. This is the candy apple one. So let's see. I can smell the sweetness. It doesn't smell really like apple to me. Maybe I need to just put some on my hand and wash my hands with it and see. But it does smell good. It doesn't smell bad. But as you can see, it has like a shimmer to it. Like it has, I don't know. Like they put something in it. I can't explain it. What I'd like to know is, it, you can write in the comments down below if you would. It almost looks like when I wash my hands with it, like when I rinse my hands, it will it leave like this iridescent type sparkle on my hands when I'm done? Because it almost looks like it's going to leave this sparkly stuff on your hands. All right, the next one, let's see what that one smells like. This is the caramel. Cinnamon caramel swirl. Let's see what that one smells like. All right, again, can't break into it here. I think I got it. All right. This one smells good too, but again, I'm getting some of the caramel. I'm not getting much of the cinnamon smell, but I can smell the caramel smell. So, all right, well, I hope they're good. And again, you can see this one has also the shiny, shimmery stuff inside of it. Yeah, I hope it doesn't, because, you know, my husband goes to use this. I don't think he would appreciate sparkly hands when he's done. don't think he'd like that. So that's my little bitty haul. That's what I got. I didn't go overboard this time. And like I said, I had to step outside my comfort zone and order a couple of things I've never ordered before. So if I like these, I may do it again. This cinnamon caramel one says it's golden caramel, fresh cinnamon, and brown sugar. And the apple one says red apple, winter rose petals, and candied orange. So we shall see about that. But I am happy with the candles especially, and this especially, because I put some on my hands. Oh, I'll be walking around after I put some on. I can see me in the stores going, people think I'm sniffing. What is she sniffing? Anyway, all right, guys, I'm going to get off here, put my stuff away. I'll be back here shortly with another haul for you guys. I got a holler haul sitting over here to my side. So, all right, remember to always let go, let God. No guts, no glory. God bless each and every one of you, and we'll see you in just a few minutes. Bye, guys. We love you.